Today we're going to change the touch on iPad 2. It's really broken, and then on the edges also it has some damage. So what I did was that just to be sure that if when we change the touch it should fit properly, I just opened a bit from here to push it. So as was saying that I just widened it, or say straightened it a bit, so when we put the new touch it should fit proper. Now we going to heat it up, my favorite tool, always shows you, and going to use a lower level, and I'm going to concentrate on to the sides so we don't damage the LCD or anything. It's going to take about 3 to 5 minutes, that's the usual timing that I use. Heat it up nicely so it can remove, but don't concentrate on one place, we don't want to put a spot onto the LCD. I'm gonna heat it and I'm going to pause it for you to save up data. So now I'm going to start opening it, but you have to be very careful, as I keep mentioning again and again, we don't wanna damage the LCD. This is what I don't like about these devices. It's not going to be easy job, I can see it, because it's an iPad 2. We used to make them like pretty stubborn with this double-sided tape. But we won't lose the patience and going to heat it up again, bit by bit, bit by bit. And I'm gonna pause it because I need to heat up for quite a long time. I heated up a bit. I'm going to try to pull it up a bit. More you're going to heat up, it will be easier for it to open. But at one point you want to see this flexes sometime, while the heat goes in there, it pops up and you can break that also. So be careful about that. If you hear the music in the background, that's my family watching a movie, and against my rule I brought some work at home, which I do usually don't do. I'm a very talkative person, so I'll talk things which are not even relevant to repair, but can't keep my mouth shut while busy repairing. Everyone has, you know, their thing. Some people listen music and stuff, and I keep talking. So this side is pretty much done. Now here at the bottom, we want to be sure that we don't break Wi-Fi area. There is Wi-Fi area. See, this is what I don't like. Oh. I'm gonna pause it and clean it up so it doesn't go into my eyes. So we're going to start it again. Here is the flexi, so if you're opening to do some other repair, well, if in case you get other repair, because mostly this is about touch, so I'm going to just slice this this flexi so I can remove the touch easy. Make sure that you have the iPad off. Sometimes these things get short and can damage some other components. So there, I cut it. The remaining pieces, once we have separated the touch, we will remove it. Now we're gonna start on top. It's coming off easy, so we're not gonna do a haste. I think there is either Bluetooth aerial or something is there. I'm opening a laptop after a long time. Laptop, I'm saying, sorry. iPad. I'm gonna heat up more. So as I was saying, there was something, I think this is Bluetooth aerial or Wi-Fi is down here, so it must be Bluetooth. Front camera. Okay, the touch is off. That's a broken one. Now we're going to take off these bits and pieces. One thing I want to tell you, as much as you can try not to touch the LCD, once the thumbprint is there, it will be very difficult to clean this thing. So I'm gonna pause it and heat up here and on top. And the here. Pieces and bit by bit it will come off. See, just one piece went into my thumb. Protection, you know, makes your work slow, but I will still advise you to put some glass protection glasses for the eyes, because these things are very sharp and very tiny. I have to heat up again, so I'm gonna pause it. I heated it up a bit. Sometimes I hate these things, man. Comes on in small pieces. Take your time. This is not a quick fix. Don't break anything or injure yourself. You can even separate the LCD. I did not do. I told you that after so long I opened this thing, so it's like not a routine job for me. And you should remove the LCD so you can avoid this whole mess. There are 1, 2, 3, 4 screws onto the four corners. And I'm not doing it for the money. They are discussing about it that I'm making a video because you get some money. I love my job. That's the only reason I'm doing, although if I can leave it, I'll leave it. But I like to fix things. And obviously for the money I do. I'm gonna pause it and heat up again. It's a quite painstaking task to do bit by bit, but no choice. So keep doing it until it comes off. Most of the iPad structure is same. The newest one has Now we done. Now we must remove the LCD carefully. Place these screws onto a safe place. My phone battery is a bit low, so flash is not working. For that, it might be a little bit dark now. Four screws into the side. Now we're going to remove. This is the touch flexi, remaining part of touch flexi. Now we're done with the removing of the touch. We can install new touch, but first I want to clean these marks. This is a mission. Once it is cleaned, just remove the LCD. Turn it to the side. Might not look like doing the job professionally, but everyone has a way. This flexi is a touch flexi. Push the locks in so it can hold it. There was a protective tape on it. When we are closing it, if it shakes, it stays in contact. I'm gonna put this double tape underneath there so the touch flexi can stick to board and we don't develop any kind of gap in between. Nicely, because if it gets a curve here we go, this is the way that we're gonna put it in, like original fitting. One thing I always forget whenever I do the iPad, that these shit dual sided tape is still there, and they always put this plastic which protects it from scratches under the tape. I'll show you what I'm talking about once this is removed. completely removed. Now we're going to place the LCD on its place back. I'm gonna pause it here. My phone decided to move. As usual, my favorite thing that I'm gonna use is my glue onto the sides of the iPad edges. Reason for that, if there is any gap developed between these corners, so and stick it to properly. I'm gonna put a little bit drop under the Wi-Fi aerial as well. Once it is closed, it will hold this plastic underneath there also. So when it dries off, stick properly, and on top as well, onto the corners. I'll go all the way around four corners and onto the edges. I'm gonna pause here and just glue it. I've put all around the glue. Now we're going to put the LCD back onto its place. So we can start closing it. Take your time and put it onto the right place. Don't force or press. These things, sometimes they are very sensitive, fragile. They break easy. Give your full attention to it. Do it patiently. Once the LCD is sitting down, then you can start putting the screws back. I'm gonna change the position of the phone again. It's time to put those screws back. The last one. That's usually the case, that the last screw is always difficult. At this point, I want to show you something, that this side of the touch is covered with a protective plastic layer inside of the touch, and this is what I hate. They always put this thing under the tape, so we have to cut it. And don't know when you get it, why I left it for the last, because I don't want to put any fingerprints there. Let me pause it and cut it with the cutter or scissors, something, or blade. I've managed to take it out under the tape. Now we're going to pull it out, all of it. And that's the time when we, at this point, we're going to close it. The reason of that double sticky side tape putting under the touch was, so sometime, or most of the time, you get a gap here, but if you have put the strip nicely, you won't get that gap. And one thing I did stupid enough, not to check the touch before I fit it. Let's hope so it's working, because it's too late now to open it and check it. So just check all around the corners, or if it is closing proper. Now it's the moment of truth, if this thing could work, because I didn't test it before I closed it. It's switching on. LCD was always alright. I'm just going to fill up some glue in these gaps. If you can see it, I don't know if it is going to focus it, because my phone is on low battery. The part that I like straightened it so the touch can fit, you can see that It's fitting all around the corners nicely. Only this side we need some glue to fill it so dust doesn't go underneath it. And the new touch or the screen gets dusty. So I'll check it just now as it's still booting. Pause it here. I don't know how long it's gonna take. Finally, it is on. Slide to unlock. Home button is working. Slide to unlock. And not now. Close. 1,397 emails. Lots of game. That's customer stuff. So this is how you pretty much change the touch for almost every iPad. In the newer versions there is a touch sensor. Please try to open it gently from the bottom as much as time it takes. Heat it up and take it out nicely, because that some of them you cannot replace it with the aftermarket, and if you change it or you replace it with the aftermarket stuff, it doesn't read the fingerprints. So all around it looks pretty much smooth and good. Please, if this help you, like it, subscribe it. Until next time, goodbye. Take care.